Greetings and blessings unto my brethren and sisters, to YAHOVAH'S HaMashiach, Or Dehai, the light of life. Hallelujah. Jehovah, the glorious Orai of Israel, the light unto the world. YAHOVAH'S HaMashiach. And we thank you, Jehovah, that your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. A menorah unto our path. We thank you, Jehovah, that your word is a menorah unto our feet and a light unto our path. Hallelujah, Jehovah. And I thank you, Jehovah, for who you are. And I bless you, El Elyon. I bless you, Most High God. I thank you, Father of all creation, Father of lights, Father of life, Father of love. Thank you for your word. And thank you that your word is proven right and true in our lives. And I thank you for the dream that you have given unto me to share with my brothers and sisters. And you want to make sure, my brothers and sisters, your dream comes from the Most High. If it doesn't come from the Most High, don't follow any of these dreams that don't come from the Most High. It's got to come from the Most High. Hold on, let me pause and so I can read to you a scripture about this, all right? Here we go, I found it. I'm going to read out of the Holy Bible, the Stick of Yahurah. This comes out of the book of Sirach, one of the books, the nice counsel was threatened and removed, one of the books of Okma or wisdom. And those who have the Holy Spirit have the spirit of wisdom and the fear of Yehovah. So they remove these, the main part, they remove these books because they have the Holy Spirit, because they have wisdom and they have charity, the supreme pure benevolence of HaMashiach. That's why they remove these books. Or the way you could say it is because they have love and wisdom. So that's why they remove these books, because they're nice, you know. In case you don't know what nice is a power of darkness. Nice means stupid. It comes from the root ignorant. It comes from the root of stupidity, the root of ignorance. All right? Nice means stupid, ignorant, foolish, fake. You don't want to be nice, people. But you do want to be loving and peaceful and joyful and kind and wise. All right? Let's read a little bit from the Holy Bible, from the Stick of Yahurah. Senseless people have empty and false hopes, and dreams excite fools. Those who pay attention to dreams are just like people who grasp at a shadow or pursue the wind. What one sees in a dream is a reflection, a face looking at its own likeness. What will be made clean from something unclean, and what will be true of something false. Divinations, omens, and dreams are empty. The mind has fantasies, just like a woman in labor does. Unless the Most High, Yehovah, sends a dream by means of a visitation, don't pay any attention to it. Dreams have misled many, and those who have placed hope in them have fallen. The law will be fulfilled without lies. Wisdom is a faithful person's mouth and fulfillment. Oh, wow, that's why they removed this book, because they didn't want the faithful people's mouth to be a fulfillment of Yehovah's wisdom. Exactly, Raphael. They just wanted them to be nice. You know what I mean? Okay. Unless the Most High sends a dream by means of a visitation, don't pay any attention to it. The Most High has sent me this dream, and he keeps placing it upon me again and again and again and again and again and again and again. This is the eighth time. It's not that I'm disobedient. I just want to make sure Yehovah really wants me to get this out to you, because it takes everything that I have to work against the devil and demons and to work against hell to release Yehovah's loving kindness and mercy to you. Like when Daniel prayed and all the angels had to fight through the prince of Persia to get an answer just to his prayer. Not just a blessing, just an answer to his prayer. It's like that now. But trust in Yehovah and YAHOVAH'S HaMashiach. Your answer will come. Your prayer will be answered. And here's the dream. I'm in the dream. I'm in this. I'm with all these people. I'm with you. I'm with all my brothers and sisters. I'm in these dark waters. And I'm telling them not to fear and to trust Yehovah and to have faith in Yehovah and to trust in his word and to have faith in him. If I put it in English, to trust the Most High, to have faith in him and have faith in his son, to trust God and to have faith in his word. and I'm right, I'm on the outside of the people and the people are behind me. And then I see a shark coming and it's coming full blast at me in the water. And I'm like, is that a shark or a dolphin? And the Holy Spirit said, it's a shark. And then I see its fin coming, it's gray. I'm like, oh crap, I don't know if that's a hammerhead or a great white shark, but it's coming right to me and I'm telling the people, don't be scared. And the shark's coming right as to like rip us apart and destroy us, to kill us, to murder us. And I'm there and the Holy Spirit's telling me to tell them, don't be scared, don't have any fear. And yet a shark's coming to devour us. And then the shark comes full blast. It opens its mouth. And right when I see all its teeth and its eyes, and I'm looking at it, and it's going right when it goes, I mean, right when it's getting ready to hit me, and its teeth open to bite me, bam, it gets hit by a killer whale. And this killer whale hits it out of the water, and then two other killer whales come up and they grab it. One rips this part and one bites this part, and they rip it to shreds and they rip it down into the water. And then these killer whales take off, and the killer whales protect me and my people from the sharks. And I asked the Holy Spirit, I said, was that dream from you? And the Holy Spirit said, yes, Raphael, that comes from me. And the interpretation belongs unto Yehovah, belongs unto God Most High. And the interpretation Yehovah has given unto me, or will give unto me, and this is the interpretation the Holy Spirit said. Are you ready? The dark waters represent the world, or the darkness that has covered, the gross darkness that has covered the people. And the sharks coming are the demons and that have been released, and the evil spirits, and those who are, yes, Raphael, those that have been released, that have went through their time of punishment, and now they've been released for this time to do what they're released to do. They have been released for this time. The spirits that had been bound, that could murder people, have been released and can devour and can murder them. Yes, Raphael, the sharks. It's a hammerhead shark that represents something too. Its eyes were pure black. There was no light in them. And its eyes were looking at me right before it went to bite me. And right when it went to bite me, it was so prideful and confident it was going to get me. The killer whale hit it, and then hit it so hard it knocked it out of the water into space, and then two other killer whales went up and ripped it into shreds. I mean, they just ripped it in shreds in the blood and just swallowed it, and they loved it and ripped it down. The killer whales represent the warrior angels, or Michael and his angels coming to stand for us at this time, for me and my people, Yehovah's people, the people of Israel, the redeemed of all the earth, the redeemed of Israel, the redeemed and ransomed of Yaakov. Hallelujah, Yehovah. I hope this encourages you. My brothers and sisters, no matter what it looks like, they will not be able to lay a hand or a tooth on you. The killer whales, the holy angels, will preserve and protect us even to the destruction of our enemies. In the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, or Yeshua. Another way you can put it, the fullness of Yehovah's wrath, the fullness of Almighty God's wrath, will come and preserve and protect the righteous from the wicked, even if it so be by the destruction of our enemies. So be it. In the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, Yeshua. Hallelujah, Yehovah. Amen.